So it kind of annoyed me because I'm trying to remember what that tune name. Don't tell me. No, don't tell me. Is that Jackie Me Too? Is that Jackie Me Too, don't it? Yeah, man. Don't tell me what it name, man.
Foundation.
Gosh, me, I try to remember the tune name. Well, don't ever go tell me, because I can't remember.
But you're right. You have the right.
It's a Jackie Me Too, right. I know it's a Jackie Me Too, but I can't remember.
What's the name of the song?
Drum Song.
There you go.
I know it was Jackie Me Too. Hello, everyone. Welcome to Smile Jamaica. It's morning time. Obviously, it is Wednesday. We have a band. It's a band Wednesday morning. And later on, you'll see the outstanding Leroy Simmons with that group that started us off. We welcome our friends on OneSpotMedia.com, Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat at SmileJamTVJ, and also on TelevisionJamaica.com. By the way, it's the final day of February this year. I say this year because, you know, there's someone who works here. And I was supposed to tell her happy birthday, and I can't remember her name, but her birthday is the 29th. And we do have no 29 this year.
That's so February 29th is her birthday.
But we do have February 29 this year. So, I'm serious.
I know.
Her birthday is...
How does that work?
Well, she said I should tell her happy birthday today.
Right.
But her birth date officially is February 29, which is...
Okay, confusing.
She was born in a leap year.
Oh, that's cool. That's different.
So every 4 years, her birthday come around. It's interesting. But it is Smile Jamaica, and we have a great show as we always do. Boy Empress Camille, I love the outfit there.
Thank you.
You wear it well.
It is from Africa.
You know, you are the reason the outfits look so wonderful.
They're wonderful outfits, but you're so beautiful.
Thank you. You bring them off.
Thank you. And you know, what you're doing this morning is a great example for all the people out there. Lift somebody up today and tell them they look beautiful. Yes, that's. Thank you for the compliment. This is an African piece by Etal, the store Etal. So I want to thank them for my fabulous outfit and earrings.
Yeah, but you don't need any lifting up, you know. You're always so high.
No, I'm high, but I'm high because I am lifted by those around me. So, you know, people like you who lift me keeps me going. So I thank you. I'm grateful for your compliments.
Zakiya, check that out. I'm not certain you're right, Zakiya, but check it out.
All right. What'd she say?
No, it's something she said to me. So.
People talk in his ears, people.
Yeah.
Well, just so you know.
But you're all right, though.
I'm all right.
Oh, the young ones.
My young ones are great. Thank you so much. Yeah. And it's good to be here. I want to say as well, join you in saying good morning to our viewers across the world on OneSpotMedia.com. It's a beautiful day in a crazy world. And we promise to give it to you as real as we can, to have some fun, to inspire, to educate, to enlighten. And on behalf of the entire Smile Jamaica team, put a smile on your face because we're about to get going on this show.
Yep. All right, so every country's rules are different and we've got 12 bizarre things to show you that are banned across the world. And maybe you need to ban your kids from a couple of sites when we touch internet safety.
Mm-hmm. And it's safe to say that Natalia Oh is our go-to guru on fashion and home decor, and she tells us what's trending later on.
And it's been a trending topic since last week. Later we talk about the oil found on the island. And then it's Founders Week at the Edna Manley College. We chat with a few familiar faces later on.
Edna Manley College of the Visual and Performing Arts,
to be exact. There you go.
And it's food very familiar to me. We've got some West African cuisine on the lineup that will have our taste buds working up a sweat.
You cook African stuff? I know you have a restaurant, African restaurant, but do you cook personally African stuff?
Well, let's just say my husband runs the African restaurant. I just like to eat there. I cook, I do. I try at home, but not as much. I cook a lot, but not enough African food at
home. What's the difference? Is it in the way you cook it, or is it just different stuff?
It's a menu, because somebody who loves to cook at home, I will cook Vietnamese food, and then I will cook something African one day. Like one day I did a stew in the hardo bread, the Magiawan recipe. So whether you're vegetarian or meat, just cook a stew, whether it's a veggie stew or a chicken stew or a curry, a beef stew, and you cut off the end of the bread and dig out the hardo parts and put it along on the thing, and you put the stew in the bottom of the hardo bread. I know you like bread.
When you do that?
It is.
You personally?
Yeah.
You're a big chef.
No, man, I love to cook. Well, that one I took from Cafe Africa, but I did try it. I did try it at home as well.
All right, folks, plus how you can sweat it out with soccer. Our Greener Pick will have some personal fitness trainers, and they'll do some warm-ups later on. But first, we get things heating up with our hot topics.
Did you bring your workout clothes?
No, you. I can't work out in that. All right, this
this case
trial been going on for a while. Michael McLean is in trial for killing six members of a St. Thomas family, including four children. He closed his case yesterday. That is the case for the defense. McLean's legal advisor, Carlton Coleman, declared it. That is in the Home Circuit Court. McLean is representing himself, apparently. The trial was again adjourned early as Coleman requested time to consult with McLean before making his closing arguments to the jury. And it says closing arguments are scheduled for today. So he's on trial for killing his former girlfriend, Terri-Ann Mohammed, her son, Jesse Ogilvie, as well as her niece, Patrice Martin McCool, and her children, Lloyd McCool, Jihad McCool, and Sean Chin. That was February 2006. Wow. Well, there you go. So they're trying to, I guess, as they said, closing arguments today. He's saying that he never did it. They're saying that he did.
Boy.
So I guess, we will get more about that, or hear more about that. Wonder why he would want to
represent himself? I was going to ask myself the same question.
We've seen that happen before, and some people are suggesting that you shouldn't represent yourself because you have the legal luminaries who know what they're doing. Mm-hmm. So that's that. What's the next one?
Next one. This is a terrible, terrible case, especially looking at history. But a Texas teen lied about being raped by three men. There she is, a Caucasian teen. Lied about being raped by three black men. We've heard this story over and over again. But the North Texas teenager pleaded guilty to four felony charges of tampering with physical evidence and government documents in relation to false reports of kidnapping and sexual assault by the three black men. She's very remorseful for what she did and what she said, and that's why she decided to plead guilty. Boy. Anyway, she'll be sentenced March 20th. Her plea deal has two possible punishments, regular probation or deferred adjudication, which often involves in fulfilling a requirement such as a treatment or community service. Neither involves jail time. Okay. She walked into a church wearing a shirt, bra and underwear, said she'd been kidnapped with three black males wearing ski masks, according to the reports. The men assaulted her, she said. Two raped her and held her down. She lied and said. Investigators, however, thankfully noticed the inconsistencies in her story within a few minutes. And medical workers did not find any evidence that she had been raped. And the holes in a pair of blue jeans discovered at the alleged crime scene didn't match her injuries, according to the Dallas Morning News. The pieces weren't coming together. She was actually upset after she had a fight with her fiance. Oh, and that's the story you gave? Well, I hope it... We call for jail time. But anyway, history repeats itself. I'm just not comfortable with this. Oh. All right, reunion.
Who?
Spice Girls. Spice Girls.
Isn't David Beckham's wife one of the Spice
Posh
Girls?
Spice, yes.
Victoria. She's one of the Spice Girls, right?
Mm-hmm. Spice Girls, yes.
They're supposed to be a big thing?
They were like the biggest thing back in the day, like the biggest thing in the 90s.
Okay.
And apparently they're going to be performing at the royal wedding. That's a real reunion comeback. Yeah, they got an invite from Prince Harry and Meghan Markle.
Well, I don't... They're a singing group, right?
Yes, sir.
Well, I don't know if I know one single song with the Spice.
Oh, God.
We don't have anything with Spice.
Oh, God,
Girls,
go back. Give me one of the songs.
You know any song that they know?
I do, but I'm having a quick... Because, you know, right... I was in a girl group, too, you know.
You were in a girl
five,
group.
And I was the only black girl in Australia. We were signed to Sony Music.
You're what? The Patty
and
Girls?
I just remember we were like the Spice Girl copycat wannabes. With a one black girl.
I don't know one thing with the Spice.
What was the Spice Girl song again?
Don't worry, I know my people, I mean, we soon find a Spice Girl song.
I know, right?
I have no idea who the Spice Girl is.
All right, we'll...
Not that I'm too concerned about it, truth be told.
If you wanna be, no, my lover. Is that one? No. Who's saying that? No,
it's them.
That's it?
Yeah.
If you wanna be my lover,
What do I know that song?
Something, something.
We know that song.
Isn't what? That is that Spice Girl? That was a big
one. Okay. So, do you know that tune?
I'm trying to find a song. Give me a song. Give me a song. Give me a song.
My manager just said, appear nice then, man.
Wanna be, yeah.
That's so from my manager. Just said, so.
The wanna be was right, right?
I don't want to see noise. My manager says, pretty nice.
Mama, too much, goodbye, let love lead the way.
So they were a big thing.
Yeah, they were one of
and
the biggest.
And they are reuniting to perform at the royal wedding?
Yeah.
Is that what's going on?
Yes.
No, I don't want none of them.
But
I'm all right.
Prince Harry and Meghan invited them. That's my song.
All right. So, so put it by the mic so we can hear. No, put it by the mic.
I'm singing. Together it will be just fine. What I really, really want. What you want, what you really, really want.
So they're no longer together. They're individually, they perform, no?
You gotta get with
here,
my
here,
friends.
Here, here.
Yeah, pull it up. If you wanna
get with me, better make it fair. So do you know that song, yeah? So this is a big song. Where's the first song here? But individually they perform, no?
What's Londia?
Londia, no? Hello, Londia. Individually they perform, no?
Yeah. I know Mel B's been doing some stuff like one of the talent shows. I don't
who
know if it's Australia.
B?
Mel B's the black girl. You know why I'm so connected? Because I said I was the only black girl in my group.
Okay.
So Mel B was the token black girl in the group. And she judges some talent shows as well. But anyway, moving on from that's what's going on. But can I just there are a lot of crazy things going on in Jamaica. And I'm just going to tell you all, we need to free up the crime, right? We need a wash. We need a healing. We need a spiritual intervention. We need some serious intervention. We need to end the crime in this country because the nation is in crisis, as it says on the front page of the Gleaner.
All right.
So let's fix that up. That's what's going on.
Time for some birthdays. I want to say happy birthday. Well, first I want to say good morning to Maria Lewis. Maria works at Grace Kennedy. Met Maria yesterday. It was great to meet you. Fantastic to meet you, actually. And I'm so very happy that
you
watch
our
program.
You meet a lot of
people. Yeah, I meet
where did you meet
people.
Maria? Because it seems
restaurant.
That every day you go out a lot.
I go to the restaurants.
Yes.
I don't go out a lot. Okay. I don't go out, actually.
And when you go to the restaurant, you just met Maria like that?
Yeah, I just meet Maria at the restaurant. So, and she watches the program. And thank you so much for watching. And great to meet you. Say hi to your kids. And have a great day. You kind of sound like you're upset that I meet Maria.
No, I'm just wondering how people meet you because I
go to the restaurant, I order food, go to the restaurant and pick it up. And while I'm waiting, I see people and I say hi to them.
Yes.
And happy birthday to Shireen Williams. Shireen is coming from your sister, Kareen.
Oh.
So one name Shireen, one name Kareen. Anybody else in the family have Irene in their name?
That'd be interesting.
And Noreen. Oh, yes. Okay, no surprise there. And happy birthday to Mrs. Joan Whiteley Watkiss. Mrs. Whiteley Watkiss, have a great day today, ma'am. It's coming from your daughter, Kareen, from Baron, O'Neill, Maurice, and your grandkids. And this young man, it's his birthday today. His name is Amiri. It's Amiri Nethersole. His father is an outstanding footballer, Fabian Nethersole. So, Amiri, I hope you have a brilliant. So they're confident, wicked, Amiri.
Confident.
Yeah, Amiri, I hope you have a brilliant day today, and I wish you so many more, son. And have some fun today. I think you'll probably have to go to school, but at lunchtime or when you come home, I'm sure daddy will set you up with some ice cream and stuff. So have
Sweet
a good
too.
One. And great to meet you again, Maria.
You know me. I just want to say
I
happy
know
birthday.
You very well.
Yes. So I just want to say happy birthday, happy Earth Day to all the children who were born on this day. Wake up, look in the mirror, tell yourself that you're wonderful, walk in your purpose, do something good for you, do something good for your community, do something good for your country, and do something good for the world. The Smile Jamaica and Television Jamaica team absolutely loves you, and we lift you up today on your birthday, especially our children in state care, in children's home, foster care, who feel unloved sometimes. Do know that we love you. Happy, happy birthday from Auntie Empress and
Uncle Neville. Have a great day, folks. Happy birthday. Straight play your noise.
Begin. We know there's nothing more.